Yesterday, Dr. Anthony Fauci issued a very stern warning for the United States. If we do not increase testing, and if we end the social distancing and the stay-at-home orders too soon, then the United States is definitely, inevitably is the word he used, going to be looking at a second wave of infections and deaths here in the United States. Fauci says, as it stands right now, we do not have the testing in place to go through with these recensions, I guess, of the stay-at-home orders. And we're only seeing this happen, by the way, in Republican-controlled areas. They're angry, and they think the public is behind them, but polls show again and again they are, in fact, not. The public is okay with these stay-at-home orders. They're okay having to work from home. And I know we have 30 million people in this country now who have lost their jobs or at least been able to file new jobless claims in the last 6 weeks. And even with that, these people agree that we need to stay home because we don't want the second wave. And the worst part about this is history has already shown us what happens. The Spanish flu is the best example. 100 years ago, 101 or 102 years ago, I guess it was, Spanish flu came through the United States. 3 to 5 million people died. States did, in fact, put in place orders, you know, wear a mask, stay at home, you know, these quarantines, things like that, exactly what we see today. And then, after 3 to 5 million died, seemed to go away a little bit, they rescinded the orders. 20 million people then died. The second wave came through and killed at least 4 times more people. We have already passed the low end estimate of how many people would die in the United States from coronavirus. Passed it yesterday, 60,000. 60,000 is now history. It's in the rearview mirror. And it's still going up. We have not flattened this curve, folks. We have not done all that is necessary to even begin having conversations about reopening the economy. Testing per capita is still way far behind the rest of the industrialized world. We aren't ready for this. And it all flows from the top, folks. This is because we have incompetence leading this country. A man with no government experience, no public health experience, nothing. Just a businessman who had bankrupted at least 7 different ventures. And you somehow thought that he was the guy to get us through this. Well, most people in this country now agree that he is in fact not. Dr. Fauci is the only person from this administration that we should listen to. Literally about anything. He's the only one we should or could or can and will trust. The rest of them are lying to protect their own careers, to protect their own egos, not to protect the American citizens. Dr. Fauci is out there giving us the hard-to-swallow truths, and we have to accept them. We have to listen to them. This country is not ready to reopen. And if we do, as many Republican-controlled states are working towards now, we will see a second wave that is going to be proportionally equivalent at this point, most likely, to what we saw with the Spanish flu. That is what Dr. Fauci is warning us about right now. This country ain't ready, but Republicans and the states they control are out there saying, ready or not, here we come. And the virus is thinking the same thing.